Hello guys, I'm Unblessed Data, and welcome to another review. It's a sad day. I'm reviewing the last episode, well, mid-season break episode, of The Walking Dead. So, season 4 has been pretty garbage in my opinion, not that good. Has been some great episodes, a couple here and there spliced in this, but this episode, they went over the top with everything, I have to say. Some plot holes, well, not really plot holes, just things that don't really make sense per se, and some weird stuff, but overall, great episode, a lot of action, a lot of, plot development, because, you know, at the end of this episode, they gotta go in a different direction now, but everything was pretty crazy, a lot of deaths, too, and, well, I'll get right into it. Before I get right into it, just want to let you guys know, it will contain spoilers. If you do not want to know what happened, watch the episode and come back. So, lots of stuff happened, but right at the beginning, I'm gonna go really quick through this, because I don't want to spend too much time on it, I just want to, like, get my thoughts out, but... So, the governor rallies up his people, tells them, you know, there's a herd coming, we need somewhere else safe to be. You know, there's this prison over here, let's go and take it. So, he knocks out Michonne, because he knows where the prison is, and captures Herschel and Michonne at the same time, brings them back to his little base. So, he goes and talks to Herschel and Michonne, like, you know, like, I'm gonna take them, the place back, no one has to die, I'm gonna put you up for bargaining, and I'm just gonna take the prison. That's basically what he's saying. And, you know, Herschel's like, you know, I really like this little part of this episode, this little quote. Herschel's like, you know, if you know what it's like to have a daughter, how can you threaten mine and go to the prison with, like, a tank and everything? And he's like, because they're not mine. And I think that's something that was covered with Rick and everything, but I think it's kind of cool. Just, like, that quote, I think, just really stuck with me in this episode. Even though it was happening really early on, I think it was a really shining moment in this episode, but... Megan and the governor have, like, a nice little moment, too. He, like, hugs her, says, you know, I'm gonna go for a little, I'll be back, blah, blah, blah. And, yeah, so that was a nice little part right there. Kind of, like, the last moment of humanity the governor had, basically. But anyway, so Daryl, we go to Daryl and Rick. And Rick tells Daryl, like, everything about Carol and, you know, she's gone now, she killed the people. Obviously, he's upset. But he's upset for a very short amount of time. He's like, yeah, whatever, okay, let's go tell Tyrese now. Like, I thought he, you know, they would, stretch that out a little bit, make a little story out of it, but no, like, Daryl's just like, yeah, okay, you know, we have other matters to get to, basically. I don't know if that was the right choice. I mean, I think he should have stayed angry, at least. But they go find Tyrese, and Tyrese is like, look what I found. Before they even tell him about Carol, they're like, look what I found. It's this rat, basically dissected on a board, like, nailed up on a board, and like, well... You know, whoever did this probably burned the bodies, and they're like, well, did Carol burn the bodies then? Or was it that little stupid girl she was taking care of that's basically a psychopath? And that's basically where we are right now. It's like, did Carol actually do it or didn't? Is she just covering up for the kids? We don't know. That's something that's left out. So all of a sudden, the prison shakes, and the governor is outside. Rick runs outside. The governor's there with a tank and six cars all lined up. It was a really cool shot. And then the governor pulls out Michonne and Herschel. They're on their knees in front of the prison. And if you're a comic book fan and you know The Walking Dead, if you read it, this is very similar to what happened. Now, what happened in the comics was the governor actually had Tyrese, and he put him in front of the prison and chopped his head off. So, something similar happens, which was pretty crazy, and I'll get to that in a second. But before that happens, we go to another scene with Megan, the little girl. She's digging in the ground, and, you know, Lily's a little ways away, not paying attention, and she pulls up a sign, it's like, flash flood area, and a walker just comes out of the sand where she's digging, bites her, and she's done. So, at this point, it's like, well, the governor really has nothing right now. I mean, the little girl, he basically made her Penny, is dead now, so it's like... Wait until he finds out about that. So, anyway, we go to this little thing, kind of with the kids' themes again. All the kids in the prison, they're talking, they're like, okay, they want them all to board the bus and get out of here. They're, like, just evacuating everyone on a bus. But the kids are like, no, Carol says that we should stay strong. You know, they have guns, we should get guns, and we should fight back. It's like, oh, okay, whatever. They're not going to kill kids, so whatever's going to happen with the kids, it's going to be some stupid little thing. But something actually kind of cool happened with it, and it was really a shocker for me, but we'll get to that in a second when it happens. But anyway, so Rick tries to negotiate with the governor, you know, front to face. He's on the other side of the fence. Rick's on the inside of the fence. He's like, you know, there's enough room for all of us. We can all, like, coexist together. Like, no one has to die. But the governor's like, no, you know what? We want this prison. We're not leaving. So the Rick's like, okay, we're not leaving either. We're going to fight back if you don't go. So all of a sudden, the governor takes out Michonne's sword. He goes up to Herschel and puts it on his neck. And it looks like he's about to swing. Now, this is where I have to say, why wouldn't he go after Michonne? Obviously, he has a big hatred toward Michonne. Why didn't he put the sword on Michonne's neck and threaten her first? That's my thoughts, but I guess it makes more sense that he would put on Herschel. I mean, we're more, like, emotionally invested in Herschel. And from a writer's point of view, yeah, that makes the most sense. But, if I were the governor, I would try to go for Michonne first. That's just my thought, but whatever. So he goes up to him and puts the sword on Herschel's neck. And, you know, Rick's just, you know, putting everything he can now, saying, like, okay, you know what? Let's just try to coexist. No one has to die. Like, we can live peacefully together. You know, it'll be hard, but it can work. We can live in different cells. Like, we don't have to do this. We can do this a peaceful way. And, you know, all of a sudden we hear this whisper saying, liar, and it's the governor. And it was really chilling, like, whisper. And he just slashes Herschel, and Herschel gets basically half decapitated. But right before Herschel's neck gets sliced, Herschel smiles, and it looks like he's really happy. Now, I thought that was brilliant because, really, it showed what Herschel, like, represents in The Walking Dead is basically the humanity and what's left of the humanity in the group. He's, like, the good angel, basically, and he was trying to put his morals into everyone, saying, you know, we don't have to kill. We should, you know, live peacefully and all this stuff. And at that moment, he seen Rick actually trying to, like, live out what he tried to teach everyone. And I think at that moment, he really realized, like, I made a difference. And right then, he got cut. So Herschel basically died right there. And the governor, all of a sudden, you know, basically decides, let's just go all out. Everyone starts shooting. It's a firefight. Governor gets shot in the arm, and Rick gets shot in the leg. And now everyone's behind cover and everything. But then the governor goes up to Herschel and just finishes the job and fully decapitates him. And that was crazy. But then all of a sudden, Lily comes back with the body of Megan. And the governor, you know, picks Lily up. Megan, the little girl. Shoots her in the head. Like, you know, she's dead, whatever. Now he's just fully gone crazy. He's like, we're taking this whole place down and everything. So at this point, Lily and all her sisters and everything realize the governor is probably crazy. I mean, he just decapitated someone. Like, what's happening? So, you know, the governor orders the tank to drive over the fence of the prison, which makes no sense. I mean, they're fighting for this prison to live in. If the fence is gone, there's no point in living in the prison. I mean, whatever. So they just ran over it. So there's cars driving, everyone shooting, you know, the tanks firing at the prison, stuff's blowing up. So everyone's trying to evacuate on the bus at this point. Beth is trying to bring everyone. Glenn gets on the bus, so, you know, and a bunch of nobodies. At this point, I thought the bus was going to blow up. I mean, there's a bunch of nobodies in Glenn. You know, that makes sense. Like, I mean, if they wanted to kill Glenn, it could have just blew up the bus with the tank, but they don't, which I was happy. I really didn't want Glenn to die, but, man, Herschel died. Like, that's crazy. I mean, I really liked Herschel's character. I even liked him in the comics, too. I know a lot of people really don't, but I don't know, like, I kind of wish he didn't die, but if someone had to die, it makes sense that Herschel would, because they've just been building him up, so, like, in the past, like, fourth and third episode ago, that's what they've been doing, it was all about Herschel, so it makes sense they would, because, they're, you know, now you're attached. So, now walkers are all coming in, and of course, they only come in when it's necessary to the plot. You know, they're not around when the governor's around, no, they come in when everyone's scrambling around. So Daryl actually uses a walker as a shield, which, again, makes no sense because the bullets can't go through the walkers. Like, that, like, obviously they would, but whatever. Bob gets shot in the arm, but yeah, it goes through his arm and there's an exit wound. He even says that there's an exit wound, but a walker, the bullets don't go through. That makes no sense, but whatever. A lot of action, a lot of people get shot, and again, another thing with Daryl, it's almost like he's God now. Like, he can't get touched at all. Like, he's like the survival guy, like everything about him, he just can't get hurt, which kind of makes me mad, but kind of satisfies me too, because I like Daryl's character, and I don't want him to get hurt, so whatever. So then the bus drives away with all the people, and so at least we know Glenn's safe and all them, but the little girls obviously just come up out of nowhere. Tyrese is pinned down, he's getting shot at. For some reason, he doesn't get shot, but he's absolutely has no cover at all. Like, he's hiding behind a pole, and he's not getting shot. I don't understand that either. Like, these are, like, the plot kind of holes I've been talking about. Not really plot holes, just things that are weird. But someone goes right up to Tyrese. He's about to die. the little girls come out, the ones that, you know, we have to be strong for Carol, and they shoot and save Tyrese. That was a big twist I didn't see coming at all, and I was actually like, whoa, like, right when that happened, I didn't expect that at all. So that was pretty cool. So all of a sudden, Rick starts beating on the governor. It's a fist fight all of a sudden. Bam, bam. And, you know, they're both exchanging shots, but the governor starts owning Rick and starts choking him out. And it's like, okay, the governor's going to kill Rick. All of a sudden, we see the sword go through the governor. Michonne stabbed him. The governor has done. So Michonne took her revenge on the governor. But she doesn't finish him off, which was kind of weird. I mean, like, I guess Michonne was like, I guess, you know, I'm like, I'm not even good enough for you to waste my time to finish you off. I'm just going to leave you. But I don't know, if I was Michonne, I would just finish it off, just so I know that he's not going to come back, basically. But stabs the governor, and then Lily comes up all of a sudden and finishes the governor off and shoots him. We don't see the shot actually connecting, but it's assumed he's dead. But I guess that was kind of cool that Lily actually finished him off, because it's like, you know, I trusted you, and then now I actually see the true, your true self. So I thought that was pretty cool. So Rick's all, like, battle damaged now, bloody, everything. He goes around. He's looking for Carl. He's like, Carl, where are you? He's running around, and he finds Carl. I don't know where Carl was the whole time, hiding in the corner, I guess. But he's like, oh, where's Judith? And they see Judith's little, like, I don't even know what it's called. Like, the little thing they carry the babies in, like the stroller-type things. And there's blood all in it. So it's like, I guess Judith is dead? I don't know. Maybe, you know, Beth could have picked her up. We don't know, but it's just assumed that she's dead. You know, they start crying. And Carl crying just looked horrible. I mean, just, you gotta learn how to cry if you want to be an actor. I'm sorry. But that was pretty crazy. I mean, I didn't expect it at all. I mean, Judith, I hope Judith is dead. I know that sounds kind of mean and, like, sadistic, but can you really picture Rick on the run with Carl, holding Judith, taking out walkers? Like, that's too much, honestly. Like, that wouldn't work. But that's just my opinion. Now, the last couple shots of the episode, we get a scene of the chest piece, like the king with the eye patch that Megan drew on it, in the ground, and a walker just stomps on it. I love that scene. That was awesome. And we get a scene, like, panel to the screen from the comic book. It was straight right from the comic book, just, like, modeled right after it. It was the last scene. Carl is, like, holding Rick. They're walking out, and he's like, don't look back, Carl. And you just see the prison in the back, like, burning, basically. So that was the whole episode. You know, a lot of people died. I mean, the governor died, huge. Herschel died, huge. I mean, like, come on, and maybe Judith is also dead. So at this point, the whole group is scattered everywhere. It's separated. So probably when this show comes back on in, like, February-ish, we're going to see, like, okay, here's one group. Here's what the other group is doing. Here's the other part of the group. That's what I'm thinking. But overall, it was a crazy episode. I liked it. I thought it was good. The shocks that they pulled were good. I mean, it's almost like they're resorting, they pretty much have to, this in Game of Thrones, like, just resorting to the shock of the characters dying. But I still think it works. I mean, I don't know what else to say, really. I thought it was good. What did you guys think? Leave your thoughts in the comment section below. Don't forget to rate, comment, and subscribe. And for all you Walker fans out there, keep on strolling through the streets of Atlanta, and I'll see you later. Bye.